Hey YouTube, it's the test lead, and today we're going to talk about the different roles of the people involved in a software development lifecycle. Normally, as testers, we know what we do, but what does everybody else do that's also involved in a software development lifecycle? You may hear the different roles such as a project manager or a developer, but what do they actually do? As a software tester, whether you're manual or automation, you're going to be part of a team. Each of these team members have different roles, but our goal ultimately as a team is to provide the best product for our customers or end users. So first on our list, we have product manager or product owner. The product manager and product owners are responsible for the product vision and ensuring the team delivers the right product to the customers. They work with stakeholders to gather the requirements for what the customers want. Once they have the requirements or what they're gonna promise to the customers, they then prioritize the features that are gonna be produced in this project. The product manager and product owner should provide the team with a clear understanding of user requirements and business goals, which helps in the testing process. They will work with the team to create a project roadmap. This will ensure that everything that will take place for this project aligns with the overall company strategy. Additionally, they work closely with the marketing team. That way, once this new feature is out, they can help push it to our customers. So in regular terms, the product owner or product manager, they're gonna talk to our customers. They're gonna ask them, hey, what new features would you like to see from our company? What will keep you as a happy customer with our service or product? Or on the other hand, what will make you become a customer of our service or product? What features? What should we bring to the table? After gathering this information, the product owner or product manager is going to create requirements or things that we're promising to the customer. These requirements are going to be used later on to develop and to test against. Next on our list, we have the project manager. Project manager is responsible for managing the project, including planning, scheduling, resource allocation, and budgeting. They're gonna coordinate with the team to make sure that the different milestones that are set are actually going to be met. They can then communicate this progress to the stakeholders or customers. The project manager ensures the project is completed on time and within budget, which is crucial for the testing process to take place as planned. They also manage risk and issues that arise during a project and ensure the team is working efficiently. So, what does this mean in regular terms? Think of the project manager as the overseer or the parent, and they're saying, this is our budget. We're gonna allocate these developers and these testers to make sure this project works as expected. They will then keep tabs along the whole project journey to make sure, are we on the correct timeline? Is this milestone or this achievement point being reached in a time that we expected in? They're gonna then relay that information back to the stakeholders or people who are invested in the project. After the project manager, we have the team lead. So the project manager does more high level work. The team lead does managing of more of the day-to-day work. The team lead is responsible for leading and managing the team to ensure everyone is working towards the same goals. They provide guidance to team members, resolve conflicts, and ensure the team is functioning efficiently. The team lead will work closely with the testers to make sure that we have all the resources that we need to carry out our testing processes. The team lead is also like a liaison where they're bridging a gap between different departments. Let's say the tester is over here and they need information for testing from a different department. They can go through the team lead as a connection point to say, hey, can you find out where I can get this information from, which team has it? They will then connect you with that team and then make the communication start. So team lead in regular terms, like I said, the project manager is up here, the team lead is under them. The project manager sees more high level stuff, the team lead is gonna see more the day-to-day stuff. They're gonna actually be on the ground and see, hey, what are the developers doing? What are the testers doing? To make sure the day-to-day stuff for the project is going as expected. Whereas the project manager might check in week to week, the team lead is day to day, they're gonna say, what has to be done, what was accomplished already, what will get done today. And on an average day, they're going to communicate with the developers and the testers. Next on our list, the software developers. Software developers are in charge of writing code to develop the application or software. They will work hand in hand with the testers to make sure that everything else promised in the requirements to the customers is actually being accounted for once they develop it. Because after they develop it, the testers are going to test for it. Developers also provide technical support to testers during the testing process to help resolve any technical issues that arise. They are responsible for coding and ensuring that the software is scalable and can be easily maintained. So in short, the developers write magic code to bring the vision that was had initially to life. So if the vision or what we promised our customers was a beautiful website, the developers will write code to bring our beautiful website to life. Next on our list, we have UI and UX designers. They are in charge of the look and feel of the application. They're professionals who know what's the best look and feel for applications that customers like. So any application that you use, the button placement, the colors, all that stuff, a UI or UX designer probably designed it. Their job is to make sure the customer experience is as pleasurable as possible. If the UI or the visual presentation of the webpage looks funky and it's hard to navigate, then no one's going to want to use it. So we use UI and UX designers who are professionals and what the customers want to say, hey, put this button over here. Use a bright blue instead of a dull blue. And at the end, they usually create wireframes or a mock-up or a visual presentation of what the application should look like. And now we have our favorite part, the testers, either manual testers or automation testers. The testers are responsible for testing the application or software to make sure that it meets the requirements that we promised to the initial customers back when we created the vision, and to make sure it has as few bugs or defects as possible. A bug or defect is when we have an expected behavior, but when we actually do our test, something else happens. For example, a login screen. An expected behavior would be if I put a correct username and a correct password and press login, I can log in successfully. However, when I do my testing, I put a valid username, a valid password in, and I press the login and saw an error message. So that's a bug or defect. So we gotta make sure during our testing, we limit these. Once we find them, we create a report for them and let our team know. Then once they are fixed, we'll retest them and then give it to our customers. Automation testers use automated testing tools to execute test cases and verify the functionality of the software application, while manual testers perform tests manually to ensure the software application is working as expected. Testers create test plans, write test cases, execute tests, and report bugs to the development team. So in short, testers test. We had those initial requirements or we promised to the customers. Now we're gonna test to make sure that the developers actually gave all those promises in the application. To do that, we create test cases and test scripts to say, this test case will test against this requirement. That's how we ensure everything we promise is actually present in a software or a website. Next we have developer operations or DevOps. DevOps is a culture that promotes collaboration and communication between software development and operations teams. DevOps is in charge of making sure that we provide high quality and reliable software. They are also responsible for managing the infrastructure and deployment of the software application. So in short, the DevOps makes sure that all the code that was created in the testing environments actually gets deployed to the production environment safely. And once that's done, that the code is reliable, sustainable in a production environment. We have two more, so please stay with me. These last two will be really fast. Next up, stakeholders. Stakeholders is a big umbrella term which includes any individuals or groups who have interest in the application or software. This could include customers, end users, and investors. Stakeholders will provide feedback on the application which will be used to improve it. Testers may work closely with stakeholders to ensure the software application meets their needs and expectations. They collect feedback, prioritize bug fixes and improvements, and provide updates on the status of the software application. So what does that mean? A stakeholder is anybody who has any interest in the application. That could be the customers, the end users, the investors, anybody who benefits from the software being successful. And last but not least, customers. A customer is a type of stakeholder. Customers are any individual or a company that uses the application or service. Just like with general stakeholders, customers provide feedback about the application. If there's any problems, they communicate that back to the team. They will also communicate how user-friendly the application or software is, which is crucial for our customers. And now, let's wrap it up. Software development and a software development lifecycle involves a lot of different team members. Each team member has their own specific role, but we're working together for the same common goal, to provide the best product for our end users or customers. As a software tester, working closely with the different team members can help your process to become easier and easier, and making sure that we're testing for what the customers actually expect and need. By working together with all different team members, we can ensure that we're providing the most high quality product for our customers. If you found this video helpful at all, please like, share, and subscribe. If you need help on your QA journey, check out my book, QA Must Know Vocabulary. I will also be coming out with another book very soon, as well as courses, so please subscribe to my email list on my website. It's free, so you have nothing to lose. But most importantly, don't forget, learn something new today.